Hey everyone, welcome back to Kettle Haven Ranch. I'm Steve. Today we have problems with the tractor. It's not starting. We're going to go through a lot of different reasons why. I already know, but stick with me and let's see what's going on. There goes the barn cat rubbing on the tripod. What a great start. Well, anyway, as I was saying, let's try to get this running. See what's going on. So as you can see, I managed to get it started. Very cold, a lot of smoke coming out at first. The problem we're having isn't the fuel. It's 32 degrees. That shouldn't be a problem, right at the moment at least. If we were 10 degrees cooler, I guarantee it wouldn't have started. We could not have got this going. The reason being is the glow plugs. I've lost a glow plug or two, or maybe all three. There's one per cylinder in your typical setup. And it's not heating up the fuel in the air-fuel mixture before it goes into the combustion chamber. That makes it very hard for it to start up. And once again, at my feet, you can't see in the camera right now, but the barn cat's going crazy because I'm down on my knees to talk to you guys on the camera. And here comes the chicken along with Foxy. Okay, all sorts of excitement going on right around the camera out of view at the moment. And the chicken's gonna knock over the camera. Okay, moving back to what we were talking about though. When you're having trouble starting your tractor in the cold, and barn cat, don't rub on the tripod, go away. When you have problems with that, starting and it just won't start, you're limited to a couple different options. Number one, providing that the tractor is sound and the engine is sound and electronics are sound, your fuel is the number one first thing to go to. Make sure your fuel filter has been changed and isn't clogged. Make sure that you don't have a lot of water or moisture in the fuel, you bad fuel. Make sure you don't have fungus growing in your fuel if it's been stored for quite a while. It can pick up different algaes and fungi can grow in your fuel. So make sure you have Kleen fuel. That's the big thing, that there's no problems with the fuel. The next step with your fuel is to make sure that you have blended fuel for the winter. You can't use your summer blend out here when it's 0 degrees Fahrenheit or minus 20 degrees Fahrenheit for that matter. So make sure that your fuel supplier is supplying you with the proper fuel. And what they do in the winter time is they blend out with a lighter type of diesel or kerosene. Will blend into that to bring your cloud point and your filter plugging point. That's not the full proper name, but I'll put that up above here. And the different temperatures at which you're not going to get it started no matter what happens. Your only option is to use different fuel blended for the colder temperatures and put in an additive. I use the Power Service white mixture additive that goes into the fuel, and I mix a lot of that in there, and this fuel has a lot in it. If you do gel up, you can always go to a product like the 911 from Power Service. That helps break down the fuel, the wax molecules, and get them back into the fuel. But if you're gelled up, you're not going to get it through the filter. So at that point, that's a whole nother video. Holy crud. You got to pull the fuel filter. You got to get it drained out. And then you can break down that wax with the 911 additive. So I've done all that with this. It wasn't to the point that I had done everything and made sure everything was perfect. This isn't my first winter by any chance at all of having cold temperatures like this. So I prepared ahead of time, and it still wouldn't fire around 20 degrees. It won't fire at all. And that is because the glow plugs are faulty. So won't get into doing the mechanics of it. You got to pop the hood. You got to pull the electronic leads. You have to use your multi-tester. Check the impedance going through the glow plugs to make sure that everything's working right to spec to your particular model of tractor or truck for that matter. And from there, then you can replace it. They are expensive, so it's sort of hard. Yeah, there's that barn cat again. Don't rub on the tripod, Posse. So it's sort of hard to go out and replace all of them at once, because I know for the Coyote, for this tractor, we're looking at $45 a piece, and there's three of them. So that sort of adds up. Maybe at 10-year mark, and I'm at 10 years with this tractor, I should probably be replacing those. So that'll get done later on. From there, hey, if you like ours, I just can't win with this cat. Never work with children and animals, right? If you like our content, please hit the like. That helps get it out with the YouTube algorithm. Get it out to more people to see it, the more people hit the like button. Subscribe and stay tuned. We got a lot more videos coming up. I'm out of practice, had some health problems, but we're getting those all worked out. So there's a ton of stuff to do here at the ranch. Alrighty, take care. Everyone stay safe.